I stand on a sleek boulevard overlooking the dock, and my bones are filled with frost and duty. They tell me someone from my family has always stood on this spot. This, or one very much like it, looking out towards the wavering sea which lies outside the city. My hands ache, tugged towards the water as if the ice in my veins longs to return to its former, more relaxed state, to roll gently to and from both sides of the body of water. Around me, the busy traffic on the boulevard is as brisk as ever, although it's easy to detect people picking up their pace as they pass by me. The man next to me, clad as he is in his crimson raiment, walks softly towards the boys and assures them that everything is all right in his golden voice. This one will be a problem. That the sea was here before us, not by much. Right after the glacial melt turned this massive dust bowl into an enclosed ocean, we came from somewhere and looked out across it. That somewhere constantly changes, revolving around the choice of tiled tropes. We either came across a mountain, or from a forest, or from a land so far away that its name only means the far place, or some other nonsense that the storytellers feel would loosen people's purses.
Which
a guardian, whose job it is to allow them to forget that which he is guarding from. Long before these guards ever began their assignations, the pain in my fingers increases and my heart starts beating faster. Sailors must have hoisted the sails. I can feel it deep within. My own personal internal glacier shifting in the face of the prospect of return. Another voyage on the skin of its ancestors, its liquid forefathers. The voyage is inevitable now. Not that there was ever a real doubt of that. The narwhals have been riding high recently, the telltale surges of their presence increasing in size. The more philosophical parts of their existence pushing against the proverbial door. Out there, I point gruffly at the sea from the boulevard, drawing the soldiers' attention from the scampering children. The brighter you shine your light, the bigger the shadows become. Do you understand? He nods and tries to swallow his panic stealthily, so that I don't see it, but I do. Not ready. His mind is too sharp, and there's too much weight behind it. The bones of who he is, the words that make his story, and his family story, and the story of his house, and his street, and his city, are too brittle. The terrible onus of my family's years and calling descending upon my shoulders. The frozen torrent of eons running alongside my blood, freezing the core of me. Swiftly around. Draw from your cartilage scabbard a broken sword, and in drawing strike swiftly down. Shatter tightly clenched arterial chains, forge from mithril fears, and in forging hold all you are. Tether swiftly escaping guttural dreams, weaved in gossamer fears, and in weaving find a measure of peace. Anoint fast decaying cerebral hopes masticated from digested pain, and present them for the world to destroy.